लेट्स डिस्कस अ क्वेश्चन फ्रॉम मशीन डिज़ाइन. यू हैव अ स्टील लिंक विद अ यूनिफॉर्म डायमेंशन. सो दिस इज अ डायमीटर इज गिवन. सो लेट्स टेक अ सिलेंड्रिकल लिंक. नेचुरल फोर्स इज वेरिंग एक्चुअली. सो इट्स वेरिंग फ्रॉम 40 किलो न्यूटन इन कंप्रेशन टू 200 किलो न्यूटन इन टेंशन. सो 200 किलो न्यूटन टेंशन to 40 kilo newton compression. So actually, because this is dynamic loading, so what I would do is I will consider the tensile forces to be positive and the compressive forces to be negative. And so if you actually calculate the mean force would be like, if you plot this is 200 and this is 40, so this it'll be just varying like this. So this value is 200 kilonewton and this is negative side. So this is, I've just drawn how the load varies. So this is minus 40, so bottom. Okay, so let me just represent minus 40. Okay, so the mean load, whenever you have these kind of loadings, let's say this is P1 and this is P2. So the mean load will be P1 plus P2 by 2, which is nothing but 200. P2 is negative because it's compressive. So minus 40 by 2, which is 160 by 2, which is 80. So, you can just see 200 and minus 40, the mean has to be 80 kilo Newton. And now the stress corresponding to this will be the mean stress, which is nothing but the load, the P mean by area, which is nothing but your 80 kilo Newton into 10 power 3, because load I always used in newtons, and area is pi by 4, diameter which is 30 mm whole square. So this is Newton per mm whole square, which is MPa, and the value I get is 113.17 MPa to the mean stress. Okay, now coming to the variable stress, the variable load is nothing but the amplitude, and amplitude is basically from the mean. Like if you look at this figure, the mean would be 80 somewhere here. From 80 to 200, what is the difference? So it is basically 120, so that is how you find out from the graph. From 80 to, 80 is the mean, which is 80, and from 80 to the max load is, either way you can subtract the peak load minus the mean load, which is 120, or you subtract the mean. You see the difference between the max from the mean or mean from the minimum. So either way it is 120. The other way of doing it is, irrespective of the sign of P1 P2, the variable is always P1 minus P2 by 2. So it is 200 minus of minus 40, which is plus 40 by 2. So this becomes plus, don't confuse with minus because P2 is already minus. So this is 240 by 2, which is 120 kilo Newton, and the stress corresponding to this would be sigma variable stress, which is 120, the same way how we did for the mean stress, by pi by 4, 30 whole square. So this value is 169.76 MPa. So we got mean stress, we got variable stress. This is the two starting calculation which you have to do in any fatigue problem. Now what is given is, you need to use the Soderbergh criteria, which basically, if you recall that straight line, the sigma mean by sigma yield, in Goodman's we use UTS here, so it is yield, plus sigma variable, which is the amplitude, by the endurance, corrected endurance. Okay, and if you have any factors, and this is 1 by FOS. So this is the definition for factor of safety. Okay, now sigma mean, already it is given as 113.17. yield value, which is given in the question, is 420 plus the variable value what we got is 169.76 by the endurance value which is given in the question is 240. Okay, and we need to find out the factor of safety. So from this is just calculation from the calculator, you know, you can do, and you get a value of 1.02. So the factor of safety is 1.02. So fatigue, always you have two criterias which you study at the BTEC level, which is your Goodman's criteria or the Soderberg criteria. Soderberg criteria, you use the yield. Okay, so the answer is 1.02. Thank you.